Hello students, welcome back to another lecture on ABM 359 inventory and risk management. So we have learned many things about inventory and inventory management, and in your syllabus we have a topic on inventory cycle or a cycle of counting. Okay, so this cycle of counting is nothing but it helps in inventory control. Like we will be checking the inventory on a daily basis or on a regularly basis, a quarter month or an annual, like on a basis, on a timely basis we will be checking the inventory. So inventory counting or cycle counting is nothing but it is the counting of inventory or checking the inventory on a timely basis. The timely basis may be daily basis, that may be monthly basis, or like daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, like once in 3 months, or on annual basis. Okay, and in this counting, so there is a physical inventory cycle counting and another cycle counting, like the inventory physical counting and the cycle counting. These are the two major types of inventory counting. Okay, and inventory counting is nothing but checking the inventory on a timely basis. Okay, so we'll see what are the differences between the physical inventory counting and the cycle inventory counting. You can see from the pictorial representation that here in physical counting, what happens, a human labor is required for the counting, and he will be going and like the labor will be going and checking each inventory on a timely basis, and that will be documented or recorded, and that will be verified at the end of the year. So here what happens in physical inventory counting, labor and time is intensive, like much of the labor and time have to be spent on this, more time have to be spent, because if it is a big factory, so need to go and check each inventory, what is the inventory level, what will be the safety stock, what is the reorder point, and whether the inventory reached the reorder point, is there any uncertain situations, is there any deterioration or any problems or maintenance, anything that is associated with the inventory. All these things will be done on a physical basis, and the person who checks the inventory will be in trouble, like have to check the inventory on a daily basis. If it's not done on a regular basis, then that will result to a large failure or large problems, a big problem in the inventory management. Okay, so it will results in the shortage of inventory, and all there will be many problems associated with this. So in this physical counting, the physical counting is associated with intensive, like the labor is, it is labor intensive, at the same time it is time intensive, it is much of the time have to be spent, like more time have to be invested for this physical inventory counting. Next is provide annual data on inventory variances, like it provides on an annual basis, because it is difficult for a person to check on a regular basis, on a daily basis or a weekly basis, so the reports will be presented on an annual basis only. So that again results, or that again leads to many of the problems like inventory shortages, deterioration, and all those things. Next, request facility downtime, because it needs more time, and it there may be many problems associated with, many difficulties associated with. Next point on physical inventory count is it takes place once in a year. Okay, so these are the major points associated with physical inventory. Now we will see what is cycle counting. So this is mostly practiced by most of the organizations for the inventory management, because this is the most easiest method of inventory management or inventory counting. So in cycle counting, you can see from the picture so he is holding a particular machine so that he can check the inventory. So here more labor and time efficient, like only like less labor is required, and time efficient way of counting, and it is proactively reduces the inventory variances. If they are like, it will be done on a timely basis, on a regular basis, the inventory counting, the cycle counting will be done. So what happens, the proactively, like before the shortage occurs, before that, proactively it reduces the inventory variances. Because on a daily basis or on a frequent basis, the inventory have been checked or is being checked by machineries, or it is being automatically connected with the system softwares which it proactively helps to reduce the inventory losses or shortages. And next is no facility downtime. There is no downtime required. There is no extra time required for inventory checking or all those things, because it is all associated with the softwares and all, otherwise the advanced technology has been used over here. Next, it takes place on a regular basis for a specific times. Here in physical, what happens? It happens once in a year. Now we see what are the major stages in counting and how it is helping. As we have discussed earlier, really the same. It reduces the manual error, because here it will be done by softwares or advanced machinery. So the manual errors will be reduced. Reduces the manual error. Align your inventory audit with your warehouse time frame. Like, it will be softwarely updated, so there will be no any difficulties associated with it. Accurate inventory reports will be there. So on a regular basis, the inventory cycle counting is done. So accurate information there, without any error there, the information will be provided. It also helps to identify the theft, damages, obsolescence and incorrect counting. Okay. Identify the inventory shrinkages. Shrinkage means if there is any shortages. Complete inventory reporting including missing and extra inventory list will be provided in this cycle counting. And minimizes the order cancellations, because it reduces the order cancellation with the shelves on inventory audits, because here we have a regular check and the errors are less. So it helps to minimize order cancellations, like whether to order or whether to not order, like all those, like if we are doing a physical counting, we will be in confusion whether we should reorder or we should stock more of the inventory. Here what happens, it is all already softwarely updated and used with the use of advanced technologies. Like the cancellations and the shortages will be reduced. So these are the major points to be remembered in the topic of cycle counting or inventory counting. Okay, I hope the concept is clear to you all. Thank you.